Namaste, friends. We are going to solve exercise 3A, question number 3. The question says, a person buys 120 shares of a company at a nominal value of rupees 40 each, and later on, he sells each of these shares at a market value of 42 rupees and 50 paise. You have to find the profit as well as the profit percentage. So let us just create a storyline over here. Children, suppose that person is me. I went to a company. I went to the concerned person or the share broker from where I could buy the shares of this company. Now, I bought 120 shares of this company, and for each share, how much did I pay? 40 rupees. Now, the shares which I bought for 40 rupees each, after some time, I was able to sell these shares at a price of 42 rupees and 50 paise to some other person. This is the storyline. You have to find out what the profit as well as the profit percentage. So, children, you can actually compare this sum with a normal profit and loss sum. Imagine you bought 120 eggs. Eggs are not so costly, isn't it? I cannot say that one egg is equal to 40 rupees. Say for example, I bought 120 apples because apples are usually costly. So imagine I bought 120 apples where one apple cost me how much? 40 rupees. Now, I am selling all these 120 apples at a cost of 42 rupees 50 paise to a customer who approached me. Now definitely I bought one apple for 40 rupees and I'm selling one apple at 42 rupees 50 paise. That means on one apple, am I earning 2 rupees 50 paise? Yes. So if I am selling 120 identical apples to the customer, where on one apple if I am earning 2 rupees and 50 paise profit, then total how much will be the profit that I am earning? We were learning shares and dividends chapter, and I went down to buying and selling apples over here. This was just to make the sum look very simple for you guys. Okay, so children, here the profit made on one share. Please don't write one apple here, okay, even by mistake. One share is equal to 42 rupees 50 paise minus 40 rupees, which is equal to how much? 2 rupees 50 paise. Now children, I am selling how many identical shares, or how many shares I am selling? 120 shares. Therefore, the profit on 120 shares will be equal to 120 multiplied by 2 rupees 50 paise. How much it should be? 120 into 2 rupees 50 paise, I think it is 300 rupees. So 300 rupees is the total profit that I made by selling 120 shares. Now I have to also find the profit percentage. Children, assume that this was a profit and loss chapter. In that case, if I ask you to find the profit percentage, how do we find? Profit percentage is equal to profit divided by the cost price multiplied by 100. Here, what we can do is we can take the profit of one share divided by the nominal value or the cost price of one share multiplied by 100. I'm just comparing this chapter shares and dividends with profit and loss chapter so that you know you can easily relate it, which we have already learned in our lower classes like class 7, 8 and 9. So children, here the profit percentage will be equal to the profit that you made by selling one share. That is equal to how much? 2 rupees 50 paise divided by the cost price. Here in this chapter, since you are learning shares and dividends and each and every term, like you know the buying price and the selling price all are having different terms, we cannot make use of the word like you know cost price, selling price, discount. Yeah, discount is there, but not the typical terms that we use in the chapter profit and loss. Fine. So children, instead of using the word cost price, I will use the word nominal value, because I have bought these shares at which value? Nominal value. So the nominal value is how much? 40 rupees. You just multiply it with 100, you will get the profit percentage. 22s are 25s are. So it will be 12.5 divided by 2, which is equal to 6.25%. I hope this part is clear. Children, if you want to find the profit percentage on the whole quantity, that is profit made on 120 shares divided by the cost price or the nominal value of all the 120 shares multiplied by 100, then also you will get the same answer, which I won't suggest, because this is much more easier, children. If you have to find the profit percentage, find it on one single share. Your calculation will be very easy and simple. Hope it is clear. Thank you so much, children.